Hey guys, Mr. SavintheDay here. I thought I'd give you just a little quick little video here on something that's absolutely got me pissed way off. And I know there's probably nothing I can do calling Freedom Ammunition. I've had a problem with American Eagle in the past, and I contacted them when I got squib after squib in a barrel with one of the boxes that I had, and got absolutely no response from it. So I am not even going to try and call Freedom Munitions, but I know there's 1,000 of you so followers that I have, and I don't know how many of you are into firearms or who's into hiking or whatever, but this used to be my Smith & Wesson M&P 9mm that I've shot IDPA steel with. I had nice Ameriglow sights on it that I've since removed. I took out the RAM, the new RAM for the Apex trigger that I had in there. And why? Here's why, guys. If you look here real close, you guys have seen all the videos of guys that can't get their guns open, you know, and you jam it against the table because the round is stuck here at this end. It's not coming out for whatever reason. And, you know, what we tried, I tried doing that as much as I could. I got to tell you what, Smith & Wesson, you make a hell of a firearm. Hell of a firearm, a matter of fact, it probably saved my life that the barrel didn't explode. But what happened, guys, is I had a squib round during competition. And in the heat of it, I don't know how much attention you're supposed to pay. When I buy, I don't care if it's remanufactured ammunition, I'm not hand loading it. This is from a company that's probably ISO 9000 approved. They've got quality control. It's probably all machinery operated. I'm hoping that's what it is. I'm not shooting one round and then another round and then another round. I'm shooting 12 rounds as quick as I possibly can under a timed condition. And here's what I believe happened, guys. I fired the firearm. The bullet came down and stopped somewhere in here. I just pulled the trigger again when I didn't hear the steel ring. And basically threw another round into the barrel with one here. And as you can see, it bulged my barrel. So I've been trying for 2 days to get my gun to come out of battery. I've got it out of battery. Now I can't get it back in past this point where the barrel has completely bulged. It bulged in this area here where there's a little bit more steel. Like I said, probably saved my face and my hands. So kudos to Smith & Wesson for making an extremely tough firearm. Freedom Munitions, I don't know what to think, guys. I do not know what to think. You destroyed my firearm. I've got the round that I took out, and it's yours. Oh, my gosh, I'm just livid. But I just need you guys to know, when this happens, there's not a whole lot you can do. You've got to destroy the firearm. I want to get the trigger out of this. I had an Apex trigger in here. It's probably a $150 trigger I wanted to get out of there. To put in potential in my new Smith & Wesson 2.0. I'm positive going to get another Smith & Wesson. I've got how many magazines? The old 1.0s and 2.0s take the same magazine, guys. So I'll be, you know, I've got plenty of magazines. But this is just a piece of garbage. So the backside I broke the other night trying to bang on the back of it. Look how bad I beat the shit out of this thing, you guys. Beat the shit out of it. I thought maybe it was hung up on the firing pin, like I had lost a primer, but the primer is there, perfectly nice struck and hit. So I ripped the back end up plastic out here and pulled out my firing pin, and that still didn't allow it to move. What I ended up doing, guys, was actually taking a punch against this end here and just banging the crap out of it until I got enough of a gap that I could start slowly working a screwdriver down through here until it pushed enough that eventually it pushed forward. Once it pushed forward, I was able to switch then the slide release down. You know how I have to do that. Now what do you got to do? You got to go the other way now. So I had to push back through this with the takedown lever down. Bang through this now. Now then it came back through and I could take take the barrel off. Anyways, guys, you guys need to know, caution with the free ammunition. I don't know. I put 2,000 rounds. I've got another 2,000 rounds of this stuff in there. But this is potentially what can happen, I guess, if you're not paying attention. You get a squib and you fire again. This is called the bulge barrel, guys. And from what I saw, there's only one other way to do it is to have a gunsmith come in here and drill it out. And drill it out, collapse the barrel on itself, and then you can, you know, go forward. But guys, now I need a barrel plus my gunsmith time, you know. I don't know. You guys tell me. Maybe one of you guys out there is a gunsmith, but in my book, it's a piece of garbage now, and I know I was going to be getting a firearm. There's no reason I should put that much money into a gun that I've got thousands and thousands of rounds through it. But anyways, just heads up, bulge barrel, 101. Bummer. Mr. Saving the Day, out.